It's an early morning start. But we're eager to hit the long, winding road to Tahoe. Because we're getting ready to do something truly special here. Here at the Tahoe Keys Marina, we're climbing aboard an unusual ship. This is the Tahoe Flyer, the world's smallest aircraft carrier that's recognized by the U.S. Coast Guard.
A lot of people know that the best way to view Lake Tahoe is right here on the water in a boat. But what about taking a look at Lake Tahoe from the air?
That's right, guys. We're about to float over beautiful Lake Tahoe in a hot air balloon.
The entire operation is the only one in the world that does an entire balloon operation from a boat. That includes inflation, deflation, launch and landing, all from a boat.
And when you're preparing to set sail, Captain Greg Collard knows there's one important factor here.
Respect the wind in Tahoe. So we are very picky about what weather we'll come out here with. So we do tend to cancel more than a lot of operations. You know, we have a 110-foot long balloon and it's a 100-foot boat. And if the wind changes on us or if the wind picks up on us, that could create problems.
Lucky for us mateys, the wind is on our side, and we're flying with a hot air balloon pilot who absolutely loves his job.
19 years, flying hot air balloons for 19 years. I don't have a day off for 6 months. I work May through October and I don't have a day off for 6 months.
He just loves what he's doing, and you'll see that when you're up in the balloon with him.
This mountain you guys see over here is called Mount Tulak.
And with an office view like this every day, you'd fall in love too. From Mount Tulak to Emerald Bay, Tahoe from 10,000 feet is even more magnificent.
We're doing this whole thing without a steering wheel. We do this just with the wind currents that are taking us where we want to go.
And we're not too high to play a few fun games that involve popcorn.
People love to throw it over the side and it falls at like 800 foot a minute while we're coming down. I'll have them throw popcorn again and the popcorn will float all around us.
You guys are falling right now at 1,000 foot a minute, going 17 miles an hour toward the water.
And a little splash and dash.
So now we're only like a few inches off of the water. This is pretty amazing.
Like all great voyages, this trip must come to an end. And in our case, we need to land in the middle of a giant blue lake on a small aircraft carrier. So, can he do it? Yes, he can.
Oh, man.
As spirits are raised and smiles are shared, we discovered this ride held significant meaning for Sharon Lanuet, who faced not one, but two big fears today.
Height. Yeah. And I don't like water too much either.
And this is a combination of both.
So I conquered it. I was hoping that I could do it, and I would have done it or died. But after it went up, I started crying. It was so beautiful.
I have fellow balloonists, actually, that come with me every once in a while. And I had a couple fellow balloonists that were with me one day up here, and they started crying. And I'm like, what's up, man? And they go, this is just the best thing ever.
Take it from Miss Sharon and I. With this crew and this view, Tahoe is, and always will be, a great destination in California.
It was a trip of a lifetime.